Today, we'll write a program to destroy Sudoku. If you're unfamiliar, this puzzle originated in Japan and is pronounced like this in the original.
Sudoku.
Okay, good to know. The goal of the puzzle is to fill out each cell such that every row, column, and each of the 9 3x3 boxes contain all numbers 1 through 9. For instance, in this example, this bottom 3x3 region needs a 1 somewhere. Well, this row already has a 1, which eliminates these two squares, and this column also has a 1, which means it can't be this top square. Thus, we know that the 1 belongs in the bottom left cell. The rest of the puzzle continues in a similar way until it's all filled out. So, how does a computer approach this puzzle? It is a little different from how a human would. A computer would go to the first empty square, put a legal number into it, so a number that doesn't violate any of our rules, and keep going until either the puzzle is completed or there's a violation of the rules. If there's a violation, the program would go back, or backtrack, and try a different combination until it solves the puzzle. In this specific example, the first cell can have a 1, a 2, or a 4, so the computer would put a 1 there, and then keep going, filling out all the remaining cells. If it succeeds in finishing the puzzle, then the 1 was the right choice, but if it doesn't, it will go back, or backtrack, and try a 2 in that cell, and then a 4, until it finishes the puzzle successfully. Let's code the Sudoku solving algorithm. Enjoy this short coding time-lapse. The algorithm is finished. Here we have a Sudoku puzzle that we saw in the beginning, represented as a 2D array or a matrix, where zeros represent blanks. Let's see if our program can solve it. So just pass it into this function, which will modify this 2D array, and here we go. We see the output, where the zeros have been changed to the numbers that are supposed to be there. It works very well, and it's pretty fast. So why are we doing all this other than just to flex? Well, we'll actually use our program to solve Sudoku puzzles on an actual website. So here's the website, and you can play many Sudoku games here. Depending on difficulty, you can do easy all the way up to insane. And the cool part about the site is that if you go to high scores, you can actually see what other people have been getting. So they have a leaderboard for the month, and then also an all-time leaderboard. How will our program know what the puzzle actually is? Well, for this, I will employ Selenium, which allows us to get the HTML data from this web page and analyze it and do whatever we want to do with it in Python. So here you can see the 6 is highlighted, and that data is actually in an HTML tag called TD, table data, and the 6 is inside of it. So a blank means that the cell is empty, and if we have a number inside the HTML tag, we know that that is the number that was given to us in this 9x9 grid. So let's implement that. Here's another coding time-lapse where we use Selenium to get the Sudoku table from the webpage into our code. Time to test this. So I just opened this webpage, and I'm going to type in the word numbers, which contains the matrix that was read from the page. And if you do a comparison, you can see it's actually correct. So all blanks have been replaced by zeros, but all the other numbers are there. So the bottom, it's 3100, because on the actual matrix, we have 3, 1, and then 2 blanks. So that works well. Now let's add in our algorithm. Once the algorithm generates a solution to the puzzle, I want my code to also input the answer. So it will have to click every empty cell and type in the number that belongs there. So this is me just doing it on the screen right now, but I want my code to be able to do this autonomously. As I code up this last part, I highly encourage you to like this video. Liking the video will allow other audiences to find my content and hopefully be entertained by it. Thank you. It is time to try the completed code. I'm using adblock to make sure no ads show on the webpage because it will help speed everything up. So I'm doing this on easy mode just to see how fast can our program really solve these. And look at that, it's typing the answer so fast, and the whole process took just a few minutes. On top of that, I made the program start the next puzzle immediately after finishing this one. So it's doing everything autonomously. It's submitting the answer, and it's clicking the start new puzzle button as well. So it can just go on a loop like this. I actually stared at this for a few minutes just watching it, because it's so cool how well computers can do at certain things that humans can't. So now I wanted to also try this on insane mode. So I'll change the ending of the URL from an E to an I, because the I means insane and E means easy. So let's see if there's any speed difference. So again, I'll start the program and it'll handle the rest autonomously. And let's see. Wow, look at that. I don't even see a difference. That just took a few seconds, as you can see on the right. And it just keeps going like that. So it can just grind out these points, grind out these puzzles all by itself. Wonderful. Before we see whether we can dominate the leaderboard, I highly encourage you to subscribe to my channel. Only 1% of my viewers are subscribed, and the other 99% are missing out on fun coding videos that I post every 2 or 3 weeks. If you want to see more content like this, subscribe to Tech Tribe. I quickly made a Tech Tribe account with my logo and started the program. Look at it go, isn't it beautiful? This program has solved more Sudoku in the last 2 minutes than me in my lifetime. This is crazy. Just a few puzzles in and we're already climbing the leaderboard. Look at that 8.2 second average. Beautiful. I also got ready to run this program on my Raspberry Pi, which is a mini computer. This would allow me to run it 24/7 until I hit the number one spot on the all-time leaderboard. And we got banned. I mean, it was a good run while it lasted, but unfortunately an hour into me running this program, we were blocked from this website, so I can't access it from any devices connected to my home Wi-Fi. So as you can see, if I go to this website, just like nothing happens. And I was able to take a screenshot with my phone when I was connected to cellular data, and we were number 40 in the all-time rankings. After solving 844 puzzles, we accumulated about 500,000 points, and all this happened within an hour. And I estimate that it would take us over 30 hours to actually hit number one, which makes me curious, how did the first person hit number one? Because I don't know, either they spent years of their life playing this game, or they also had a bot, which didn't get banned somehow. Not sure how. If you have any ideas, let me know in the comments. I decided to give this other website a try, so I modified my code and I want to see whether we can beat first place, so 23 seconds. And look at our code go, it's filling out those cells perfectly. We managed to finish the puzzle in 6 seconds. We are officially first and we didn't get banned, so that's also nice. All of the code that I used in this video will be in the video description. Keep in mind that if you decide to play around with this, you'll probably be blacklisted, at least for the first website. So, be careful. If you made it this far in the video, let me give you a sneak peek into my YouTube analytics. At the time of recording, which is the end of May 2021, I have about 1,650 subscribers and gaining almost 200 every month. This may not seem like a lot, but I think of it as a crowd of people who enjoy watching my content, and I'm very thankful for this crowd. If you thought this video was cool and want to join this crowd, please consider subscribing to my channel. You can always unsubscribe later if you change your mind. On that note, thanks for watching. If you have any ideas for my future videos, please leave them in the comments below. See you later!